have your attention, please? Can you hear me? I do have a mic, but I don't really like mics, so if I can get along without it, I would prefer to do that. Welcome, and I appreciate you coming tonight. The County Commission, there's four of us here, and we are here to understand what it is the future of our libraries might look like. Linda, would you mind, I'd like each of the commissioners to introduce themselves. Would you mind starting?
I'm Bill Peterson.
He is the chair of our board.
Deb Hadcock.
She's vice chair.
And I'm George Ferry.
Okay, and I'm Nancy Troutman. I'm glad everybody is signing in. I want to make sure that everybody has the opportunity to speak, and that's one of the reasons that we have you signing in. We're under a time limit here in that we're starting at 6, we need to be done by 7, which is really long enough for anybody. So we'll limit our amount of time per speaker to 5 minutes, and then if there is more time, we will go ahead and allow until 7. One of the things that I really want to keep in mind is that the priority for people who are here tonight to speak is for those people who pay the library tax. It is for those folks who receive the benefit of the tax. They will get a priority of speaking order. So we'll move forward with that. In the back, there is the availability of the PowerPoint, if you didn't get one. And also, there is a copy of the questionnaire that we'll talk about in a little bit. We also want to let you know that all meetings are recorded. Holly is taking notes. We want to make sure we get all the information that we need to get. And I want to kind of set forth the real purpose of this. You know, we are in our budget season for the county. About this time of year, we start looking at how much money we're going to need for the upcoming year. So we're budgeting now for 2016. And we set limits. We listen to the different departments and entities that we help fund. And then we decide on the budget. The budget is a provisionary by state law. It must be done by the end of July. And then we have a final budget, which by state law is required to be passed by the end of September. So this time period is a real busy time for the county. And one of the things that brings us here tonight is that we are looking at our 2016 budget, but we also understand that we need to look out beyond that. And we're looking at the 2017 budget. For quite some time, we have known and made no secret of it that funding was going to become limited for library services. And so that's what we're here for, is to explain a lot about how the funding works, and then to hear whatever comments you might have about the future of that funding and how we will fund libraries. First of all, I want to say that you don't have a county commission that wants to increase taxes, but we also don't want to be caught in 2016 looking for funding in 2017, because that isn't fair to the taxpayers either. So that's why we're starting the process of looking that far ahead right now. So just to give you a little history, we have been collecting library tax for many, many years. But in 1998, there was But opt-out is in addition to that tax you pay. So this actual ballot issue was before there was a law in South Dakota that said you had to clearly state what the voter was voting on. And this is what it said on the ballot. Shall Pennington County provide public library services? Yes means they'll require the Pennington County to do that. No means that Pennington County won't be required. And what we were looking at is an opt-out. Maximum amount would be $188,200. This opt-out, again, is before the laws were changed. It is unending. It's into perpetuity. That opt-out will exist. However, it could be not funded. So it could be zero, but it would still exist. So if you look at how the yeses are, well, yes, I want Pennington County to provide library services. But does it say that you're going to have to pay for them? No. And that is why they changed the law. It wasn't really fair to the residents who voted on this. Like, only county residents were allowed to vote on it. If you lived in a municipality, you did not vote on this. And Rapid Valley was really the group that carried it because they wanted library services and they had the most votes. So that's how we get to some of what we're doing today. So where are our library service locations? Well, we have three outlying libraries that we help fund. Hill City, Keystone, and Wall for 2015. This is based on 2015. And we have the Rapid City Public Library, and you can go to General Beale and downtown, but as of Friday, you won't be able to use this location here. Oops, I'm sorry. Gosh, I really went there. That's where I went. I'm sorry. Not too good at this either. So this is a pie chart to show you how our funding is working. Our total expenses based on contractual agreements for 2015 is $490,426. And it looks like the percentages are not there, but this slice of the pie right here is Hill City, and they receive 6%. This is Wall, they receive 3%. And this is Keystone receiving 2%. And the rest of the pie is Rapid City Public Library, which is 89%. In the next one, we show how our expenses are. Again, this is the $490,000. It is contractual. But what we're actually bringing in on our opt-out and our library tax is $472,573. So we have a deficit of $17,853. Now this next chart is a little confusing. You have it in your and you might want to follow along in your packet. I'm not going to go through all of this, but there are some things that are kind of important. Our auditor, Julie Pearson, prepared this for us. And after you get from the pink line on down, those are projections based on historic activity prior to 2016. So as we move down, this is really the projection. Up there you can see actual and 2015. The thing that I think is important to understand, you have your tax revenue. That's the library tax that we collect from people who are not in any municipal city limits, revenue and the opt-out are what we currently have. In order to continue funding as we have been funding, it would need another opt-out. So then you would have three sources of income. You'd have the tax revenue, the current opt-out, and the new opt-out. Under state law, the new opt-out would only be for 5 years. And at the end of 5 years, you'd have this discussion again. Things change, but what you really need to do is fix that value of opt-out to satisfy our deficit in spending for libraries. Another thing that I want to talk about, okay, so I said we were almost 18,000 that we did not have in funding from the current sources of income. And I want to explain how we have, for all these years, continued to be able to fund library without going to our general fund. We had a reserve that we had accumulated when we first started collecting the opt-out monies. And over the years, we have known, as that goes down, that it would eventually come to a point where there was not going to be enough money. And that's where it would be in 2017. Again, these are projections, but I definitely trust what our auditors is doing on this chart. So, it's kind of an evolved chart, but those are the key areas that you need to think about. And certainly if you ever have questions about that, as you get a chance to look at it again, let us know, call the commission office or the auditor office, and somebody will get you some answers. But at the end of the day, the commission, if they continue to go through the trend that we have through 2015, we're either going to need to reduce expenses or we're going to have to opt out so that and the opt-out would be voted on in 2016 so that we would begin to have enough money for 2017. So it seems like a lot of figures, but I think it's important to understand it's been a long time in coming, and we've managed to get by for quite a while. So county contracts, let's talk about those. In our budgeting process, these three libraries come in and they present a budget. They tell us how they spent last year's money, and they ask for more money, usually. I've not heard them ask for less, but then we lump that into all of our deliberations about all of the requests that we have, and we come up with these amounts. The Rapsee Public Library has a different contract. The contract is for 14.5% of the operating costs of the Rapid City Public Library. So whatever they pick for but whatever they determine their operating costs are going to be, we pay 14.5% of it. So they're a little different. In Pennington County, for those rural residents, they pay 20.5 cents per $100,000 in taxable value in 2014, which pays 2015 costs. So, if you live out in the county, you pay $21.50 for every $100,000 in taxable value on your property. So, what we're really here for tonight is we're really here to kind of talk about these three questions and get your responses. First of all, would again in 5 years? Or do you think you should reduce the current services so you reduce taxes? Because we as commissioners always hear, I wish I paid less taxes. I don't know any elected official that doesn't really hear that. And how do you like the current provider's locations? Are they the best bang for your buck? So those are questions that we're going to ask you if you have comments on. There are lots of options. We started a list, but it can be many different options. And certainly we want to hear those. But you could pass the opt-out, increase the tax revenue, and support current trends in contracts. Or you could increase or decrease the number of libraries. Now we have 4. So you could have 1 county library. You could only do rural outlying libraries. You could do Western Dakota only, or you could combine it in with Rapid City Public Library, or you could combine it in with the outlying libraries. There's just many different options. Another thing that is possible is you could direct your county commissioners to renegotiate the contracts to lower funding levels. But keep in mind, that could reduce your services. So there's a lot to consider here. And you can see why we're coming to people out in the community. So I guess what we really need from you is your feedback and your questions. And if we don't know the answer to the questions, we'll find you one. We've got some, we had you sign in, and I have those. Oh, you got another list there? You know, I neglected to do this, but this is Holly Hennies, and she is our commission office manager. And I don't know what we do without her. She does a lot for us. So I really appreciate Holly all you did to put this together. One other thing I might mention, next Monday we'll have another one of these town halls in Hill City, and the following Monday will be in Wall. And depending, I mean, we could decide to have a few more, but we usually try to go east, central, and west when we have this type of thing. So, let's start out with library services concerns, and if there's some comments on that.
Didn't by closing Western Dakota Botech save the Rapid City Library a lot of money?
You know, we're not going to discuss what happened. We're going to discuss how we go forward.
No, I know. Well, but I'm looking at, isn't the $450,000 going to go down to 14.5% by closing this?
No.
Can we ask why? I mean, I think the question is fundamental to understanding budgetary needs. Most of us would think if we had
we will still pay, whether WDT is open or not,
so
we will
not
still pay the library
basis.
14.5%.
Gotcha. Yeah. Now that answers it. Thank you.
Okay.
But won't their budget go down? So you're not
well.
Paying.
I don't know that.
And I guess my next question.
I want to be careful that to remind you, Pennington County doesn't have control over the Rapid City Public Library.
I realize that.
So those are really questions you should ask them. What we're trying to do is figure out whether we need to increase our money that we devote to library services. If we want to decrease services, those are county issues. Rapid City Public Library budgeting is their concern.
I understand that.
Yeah.
Okay. I understand that, but to me,
Rod, I will give priority to the people who live.
I think I could answer the question.
I did answer it correctly, though.
I think I'm not saying you're not giving information, but there's information I could give them that would answer the question. How
But we are not here about Rapid City Public Library. We are here about Pennington County financing and services.
It's a direct reflect, I think, on what the county is going to be budgeting for.
But we will budget 14.5%, no matter what. That's the answer.
So no matter what, so the negotiation of asking our commissioners to renegotiate is off the table now?
No. At this point, we are paying them 14.5%. That's current contract. Now,
yes.
If you want to ask us to do something different, we can.
Yes, that's where I was leading to her question.
Okay.
That would form my basis of where I would come to you and ask you, as we reduce sources, it would be prudent for us possibly to form a question saying, now we could reduce our funding. But I had to understand her question before I could go further, so I think it was germane. So, thank you.
And I guess the second half of the question, and I don't know if I need to go to the library, but I would assume, being the county, that how many people out there in the county have utilized these libraries? So is it worth it for the county to go on?
There are lots of different reports that go out. You'll find that you can go to the South Dakota Public Library site, and they will have reports of how many people use the library, both in county and out. We receive...
South Dakota?
No, in Pennington.
No, but you go to the South Dakota
Public Library? Because once a year they have to report that.
Okay.
And also, we get quarterly reports from everybody, and you can call Holly. We can get that information for you. But we do have a lot of people using the library.
You know, that seems hard to believe since, you know, with the internet. I mean, you don't want to look up anything on the internet.
Well, I know Rapid City includes their electronic.
But I mean, how many people?
Because they have to pay them.
Go down there to actually utilize the internet rather than just using their own. I mean, I've lived in the county 13 years and I've never once gone in the library.
I go through the drive-up. I mean, do I physically, this is the first time I've been in Western Dakota. The library downtown was to get my library card. I do everything on the internet and direct go to the drive-up.
But still have, Rapid City Public Library still has to pay for all those services for the electronic part of it. So, you know, I think that's very fair that they use it as part of their total numbers of people who use the library out in the county. I think that's fair because they have to pay for it and they have to provide it.
And I realize that.
Yeah. So I think that's fair. Yeah.
Why is the amount going up, the amount it is increasing every year?
Well, there's a lot of reasons.
Give me the top five.
Huh?
Give me the top five,
okay.
Top three.
Cost of materials, cost of the electronics kind of thing is going up every year. So that's what the library users are wanting is electronic access. So that is a big part of it. Buying any kind of books or that sort of thing is. The more that the library is used, the more they need people, the more they need to improve their facilities, all of that. So it is a normal order of business. And it would be pretty hard on any of the libraries to just, I mean, it's not going to be easy if we say we're going to finance them for less. Yeah, there's...
We're paying 14.5% of their budget. Now, the opt-out for $188,000, now, is that, we pay 14.5% of that also, or do we pay all of that?
When we figure that, we take whatever their budget is. These are just round figures, but let's say it's $100,000 for the year. We pay 14.5% of that. How we come up with our 14.5% currently is the one opt-out and the library tax. And if you added another opt-out, that would be how you would pay for it.
So the county pays the opt-out plus the 14.5%?
No.
No.
No. We put it together in one amount. And their 14.5% is their budget. It has nothing to do with our budget. So we take that 14.5% from the combined total and the tax, the library tax. So it's, sometimes that's, you know, just...
I got you.
Okay. Yes.
Nancy?
Is there somebody else from the county that has, because, again...
Nancy, I understand that. Just so you folks know, I'm Rob Pendergrove, chairman of the Rapid City Public Libraries. I think I can shed some light on your questions.
You know, Rod,
And I think the question is, how did we come up with 14.5%? Why did we pay that much of our budget? And in the past, when the contract was initially negotiated, that was pre me being on the board, at that point in time, 14.5% of our patrons were Pennington County residents.
You know, Mr. Pettigrew, that is not true. It was 14.5% was a negotiated amount. There were actually about 16 to 17% of your library members, and we considered several different things, but the negotiated amount became 14.5%. So I don't think you do have that because I was part of that. All right?
Nancy, I'm not here to argue. I'm just trying to understand.
But you are, because we are trying to hear what county taxpayers want, and you keep answering questions.
That was the first time I spoke, Nancy.
Oh, it was?
Yes.
Okay.
Excuse me. Maybe we could set some rules of decorum, because I feel very uncomfortable.
Yeah.
If we have a chairman, if he hasn't got a parliamentarian, maybe we should act at it. But I really don't. I don't come to the ledge because I don't want to do a lot of kibitzing. I came with a prepared statement. I'm ready to read my prepared statement. And then, if it gets combative, I'll just exit once I've said my piece.
I would really appreciate that, Mr. Chairman, because we don't want that either.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you. Good evening. My name is Brett Sutton. I'm a Pennington County resident. I come here to address my concerns in relation to the ongoing budget issues of the Rapid City Library Cooperation. As a citizen, I do believe that we all have to provide and pay for infrastructure. But then it should be up to those who utilize the facilities to provide for ongoing management and continuation of that resource. In my opinion, we must put a stop to this ongoing and unjust dependency on property owners to bear the burden of these expenses. It simply has got to come under control, lest the burden of loss of economic source viability will be the result. I can think of no greater case in point than what we have in front of us today. As a county resident, I am subjected to a tax burden, as are all property owners within the county, for ongoing support of a facility which genders mainly to city residents. I myself have not visited the library more than one time per year in the past 5 to 7 years, if that, as the internet, not via Rapid City Library's resource, is my valuable resource that I choose to use. You don't have to go through Rapid City Library, and I choose not to, and I think I'm a very well-read individual. I would put to you, the same could be said for most of the county residents who live far from Rapid City. It's an interesting that I heard that there was a lot of county residents utilizing that. It's information to me. There must come a time, and I think that time is now, working with the city, when you have to consider implementing a more significant use cost basis, whether that be on a per item, as in a checkout basis, or on an annual card basis, charged to those who use the facility and all it contains. We, the city, or we, the county, and city property owners have put up the supra and infrastructure. Now the predominant users of the facility should bear the greater burden of the ongoing costs over and above. Again, I thank you for your time.
Mr. Sutton, would you mind if I've got a copy of that?
I've already prepared for that. I've signed a copy to your secretary.
And you're very good at hybrid.
Is there other county residents who wish to speak?
I'm going to echo a little bit of what he said, but
sure.
I think it's totally unfair that my fee is based on the value of my property. It has nothing to do with how much I use the library. And given all our other taxes are going up, I think this is something we have to cut, and I don't think it's a this anyway. That's my short opinion. Thank you.
Yes, Bruce.
I have a question. Before we were in a contract with the Rapid City Library, did the county residents have to pay, if they wanted to use the library, they had to pay a fee to use per year to use the library?
That was a really long time ago.
And that fee is $90, I can pay that.
That currently, if you're, like, if you're in Custer County, I think it's 80.
It's 90.
I called the library January 1st.
Okay, all right. So, yes. So that, what you're saying is that if you were living out in Rapid Valley would want to use the library, then rather than paying the tax, you would pay the $90 individually?
Which is certainly, as this gentleman stated, on a more fair basis. It should not be based on the abode that you reside in and having the prejudicial tax basis for something like this on that.
Well, I'm thinking too that $90 is kind of a big chunk at once, but maybe they could do it quarterly or semi-annually or something.
They do.
Anyone else?
Nancy, I just have a curious question. Why don't you raise the library tax levy instead of doing opt-out?
Because we have state law that doesn't allow us to.
Oh.
You know, it's like any other
assessment. You can't increase the budget so much percent.
You know, you have those laws that only allow you to raise so much, and if you use the CPI, like this year's CPI, it's 1.5%, you know, so.
I've got a question. The 14.5% is of what dollar amount?
Of whatever their budget is for the year.
Oh, the total budget or just the library budget?
The library budget.
Because doesn't it say the library budget is $437,000?
Well.
That's our portion of it.
That's the 14.5%.
So
the library budget is like $3.5 million.
Yeah, we didn't. You know, like I said, we're not here to talk about library budget.
I was just wondering how we were getting that dollar amount.
Yeah, that is how it is.
And it's good to know, Nancy, that I didn't know how you came up with the percent.
Okay.
Hi, my name is Bonnie Gary, and I live out in the trees west of Hill City. And I'm in an area where there's no cell service, internet service is intermittent, there's no paper delivery, and I'm not alone. And I can handle it, but I feel for some of the students out my way, and our library has become very popular. In fact, I'd like to commend the county for what they've provided us, but you're getting a lot more for your dollar out our way because the city, of course, covers the greatest percentage of the cost. But the county, Hill City, but the county patrons are much higher from the county. And I wish you could come out and witness the number of adults using our library. Granted, we have children's programs, adults programs, but the day-to-day users are adult males job hunting and staying in touch with the world, and I think that provides a great service. Our number one expense, which is probably true everywhere, is salary. And no one's overpaid, let me assure you. No one's overpaid, but that's our biggest expense. And any programming we do is not from anyone's budget. It's all raised by the Friends of the Library. And we don't intend to change that. We're trying to do even more fundraising. But it's a pretty slim budget these days. And I think it would be a hardship for someone that lives 41 miles from Rapid City to have to depend on Rapid for some of their services.
Okay. Anyone else?
Hi,
dependent if we continue to keep the current contract. Because, you know, that makes quite a bit of difference. Let me just...
Well, the percentages are pretty small.
Yeah. We're about 55,000 goes to the outlying libraries for 2015. So what that would probably mean is, you know, that would be by 2017, according to that chart, if we didn't finance the outlying libraries and only finance Rapid City, we wouldn't have to opt out as soon, I would think, if we maintain 14.5, but that's totally conjecture on my part.
But the point is, we have no library out there then. So
big part.
Then three libraries that we're using now would be non-existent.
Well,
so we would have to
have to rely on their own source of funding.
Well, my question is, to come into Rapid, what would it cost us then? I'm assuming we get a library card, it would cost the $90?
Well, but see, that would be the county. You don't have to do that now because the county contributes that 14.5% to the Rapid City Public Library. If we didn't have any library service, then currently it's $90 for an out-of-city resident to have service at the Rapid City Public Library.
Right, property tax levy would go away.
Yeah, if you didn't finance any of them.
I added up the three costs for Wall, Hill City, Keystone, and of course that came to 52,000 something. And if that's divided by the 490, we're only talking 10.75%. Mm-hmm. I feel like the three libraries are at the firing stake for 10%.
Mm-hmm. I don't think that you should feel that way, because we are just gathering information. We are not making any decisions right now. But we can't wait till 2016 for 2017. So we've got to talk about it now. Yes.
Is it possible to keep the outlying ones, Hill City, Keystone, Wall, and maybe have the people in those areas, if they wanted, to pay for it and eliminate the Rapid City?
Yes. You know, and another thing that's possible. It's possible to use the Rapid City, and I just thought of this, but use the Rapid City amount of $90, and based on all libraries, if you're not within city limits, that library would get that $90 per person, no matter what. And that could happen. However, the problem with that is that you have to prove to us how many of those people that you say are county residents outside municipalities. We'd have to find a way to prove that so that we knew it was fair.
Library card. And library signing.
Or you can pay a portion of the $90.
Sure.
I mean,
there's lots of
options. I don't want to lose the library, but...
Yeah. So those are good options. Again, those would require a different kind of bookkeeping for all the libraries, because they'd have to provide proof that that person actually lived outside city limits, whether it was Hill City or Wall or Rapid City.
Well, if they have stats on the South Dakota Public Library.
But they don't have the list. So, you know, we don't, if we're going to pay per person, we want to know it was really per person.
Then
Mandel
said we could do vouchers.
Yeah, we could do vouchers. Well, that's really what that $90 per person would be. It's a voucher. Yeah.
You were referencing the 14.5 figure through the Rapid City Public Library being that including all the county residents, rural, that the other libraries are also county?
No. How it works, and I'll give you an example. Let's say you have 10 people who have a library card. And out of that, there are 6 that are Rapid City residents and 4 that are county. Then that was how the negotiation started. And we looked at, but we didn't have the exact figures. We were given figures on how many were Rapid City residents and how many were non-Rapid City residents. And we came up with that negotiated amount.
But then you could be theoretically including people that Hill City counts or Wall counts.
Theoretically, you're right. Theoretically, you're right.
Or you could be including Hermosa and Meade County.
No.
Yeah, you don't, I mean, in that figure.
Yeah, I don't know that, so.
Well, the other thing I think important too, though, everybody keeps throwing around this $90. That's what it costs to use the Rapid City Public Library. That's not what it costs to use the Wall Library or the Hill City Library. So if you live closer and you wanted to utilize that library, it's not going to cost $90.
Well, we got some good ideas. This was great, and I appreciate it. Is there anything the other commissioners would like to mention?
Where I came from, the libraries had the bags that they got here. They had the bookmarks, and they were all had advertising on them. Mm-hmm. They raised, I don't know what kind of money, but they always raised some money that way.
That's a good idea. But that would be for up to the library.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I didn't realize they were all so interrelated, each city and each county, and where I came from was just one big library.
So is the Rapid City Library somehow in charge of the Hill City and the Keystone and the Wall?
No, but they have been working towards kind of collaborating, helping each other, which I think is a good thing. That's my personal opinion, not the commissioners. They have their own opinions. I should always remind people that if I express an opinion, it's really my opinion, not.
If you totally did away with the library, would you have to go take it back to the vote since it was already voted into law?
It would probably be referred, yeah.
I just was curious.
Yeah, I would think it would be, yeah. But the referral would have to come from people who live outside any municipal limits.
And that's logical.
You keep talking about 14.5%. The rural people, Pennington County people out in the county, not the city, but out in the county, have to come up with the money to cover that 14.5%. As the county population decreases for one reason or other, such as the city annexing in big sections of the county, and so, okay, these people are no longer in the county, they're in the city, the people that are left in the county, the only thing that can, now, you get the 14.5%, so there's a library tax levy on our tax bill, is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that library tax levy is going to have to come up or be increased to cover for the existing people that are left in the county to cover 14.5%.
That's true.
Maybe
they ought to figure out how many people are actually using the library that live in the county or the library population.
Not to say they said this has to put a public library.
And those figures are reported from the library, not from us.
But yeah. If we went to the library now, how would they know we live in the county or the city?
They have access. I guess my personal feeling is if the, you know, according to your 10% of the and it's 90% for the city of Rapid City, and of course, I'm sure that's a lot of the population there. I personally would say if something needs to be renegotiated, perhaps the public fire.
Any other thoughts?
Is it your intention that we hand these in, or would you?
Yes, would you please?
Do you want our name though?
It's up to you, but you don't have to. We also have that on the Pennington County website, and you can go fill it in there, or if you get home and your neighbor wants to say something, they can go in and they can, on the website, complete the questionnaire. We're just trying to get a feel in as many ways as we can. It's going to take a while.
Yeah, I'd like to see a show of hands of how many of the folks are satisfied with the current system. Pardon me, the question was, how many of you are satisfied with what we're doing currently?
I'm satisfied.
You mean like the library services I get?
And the taxation. Nothing is free, but we all understand that, I hope. So we're charging, and we're fixing to have to opt out. So are you happy with the path we're on?
I take advantage of it quite a bit, so I'm very happy.
But when we raise your taxes another year, are you going to be happy with us?
I'm still going to take advantage of it quite a bit, so I'll be okay. Other people that don't take advantage of it probably ain't going to be happy.
But that's no different than not having any children in the school district either.
Yeah.
Well, why not have the people utilize it? You can pay for it.
Okay, yeah. I'm one of the people that was annexed. I live in Rapid Valley. Still consider Rapid Valley. We pay water, sewer, Rapid Valley, yeah, all of that. So when we were annexed, there, I don't know how many, I can't remember, but so the 14.5%, that just went away.
Well, no, we are still responsible for it, but your tax levy went away.
Okay. Is hers just paid through, like, the general fund?
I was curious.
Hers is paid through her city property.
City property, yeah. And it's really unfair for city residents to, this is my opinion, to pay, we collect from city residents and that money goes mostly into general fund. We don't collect specifically for libraries. Mm-hmm. But if we're collecting for libraries, for outlying areas, and the Rapsey Public Library has a higher budget than we anticipated, we have a shortfall. And if we didn't have the reserve to go to, we would go to general fund. So I have had people who are city residents say to me, and I get that, it's not fair if I'm paying taxes that go into the general fund and then you have to raise your general fund taxes because there wasn't enough that you collected in your library tax. You know, you're double billing me because then I have to pay more in general fund because we have to come up with it some way. So you've got to raise the taxes for the general fund or we eliminate some kind of services. You mean gravel a road instead of blacktop or something. But I see where the city people say that. You know, I already pay you money that you put into the general fund. It's not fair for you to take it back out of the general fund, raise the taxes to handle library services. So I get that. Yeah, Larry?
Well, basically it's broken down to, I guess, common sense. If you can't afford it and you can't pay for it, don't buy it. That simple. I mean, it seemed like not so much Pennington County, but Rapid City and the state government and the federal government, they're totally insane. But they think they got a blank check, so they just keep printing it and just blowing the thing up. And the value of the dollar and everything else just keeps going down. I mean, it's just a good example is this stupid sanitary district they put in out the valley. That's my opinion. They said, well, everybody's got to pay for it. Well, I don't want chlorine. I don't want fluoride in my water. I got a good well. Now, why should I have to pay for the damn thing if I'm not using it?
We're all in it together.
You're in everybody. You can't opt out.
Yeah, we can opt out of our taxes now.
So no matter what, Rapid City says that their budget for their library, the county's going to pay 14%.
Yep.
So they're basically giving Rapid City control over how much money they're going to get from them. No matter what they raise their budget to, they're going to pay 14% of it.
Pay 14.5%.
Okay.
So if they're not careful with their money, they're all, we still pay the price.
And honestly, you know, I don't know that I would say that's true. Okay. I want to invite you to any of the other two. Next week is 7 o'clock in Hill City at the town, city village, city hall, town hall. And in Wall, it's at the community center. I want to make sure I got that right. Again, at 7 o'clock.
How many readings are now? I only found out about it because I was here using the library.
Okay, we did have it in the paper. We've had it online. We've had it listed in our...
I don't get the paper. What do you mean online?
Our Pennington County always puts out what our upcoming meetings are.
On the website?
On the website.
Okay.
So you can go to Pennington County and you can find it there. And then we will have notices in the County Current for Wall and the Prevailer for Hill City. So, I mean, we've asked the libraries to put out an